Hello YouTube and Fire to the Horror Realm. We're up to day 37 on the extended bonus days of the 30-day horror challenge. Getting tougher and tougher. Well, not really.
Yes, it is.
Well,
I had a tough time.
I didn't. Well, I did have a tough time because I was going to choose between those two that were at the top of the list.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of them. And that, of course, is the horror film with the best special effects, and that would be practical special effects, not CGI. Stuff done creatively, not on a computer. I mean, it's obviously prevalent in almost everything. I mean, you get shots, sometimes it's intricate and it's set up for, you know, one shot and it's got to work, or, you know, back to the drawing board, or sometimes it's just someone's creativity. You know, you look at something like Killer Clowns from Outer Space, the giant clown facing off is all it was. Is just kind of perspective, shooting from behind, up high from behind a normal person looking down on someone. Made it look like a giant. But, and of course, I didn't dig it up yet, but a huge honorable mention for special effects definitely would have to go to Equinox. It's a, I don't know how to put it. It was kind of a kid's film, you know, it was done with forced perspectives to make giants and creatures come out from other dimensions and stuff like that. It was really creative. Anyhow, anyways, we are going to discuss which ones we thought were the best for practical events. And I'm going to stop rambling and let Teresa tell you what her choice was.
Mine is The Walking Dead. The zombies that were made were spectacular. They were so lifelike that they did a very wonderful job of creating these zombies. They, I don't know what I could really say a lot about it, but actually, me and my husband, we watched a show called Hollywood Treasures, and they actually had the person who actually makes the zombie mask. It was just amazing to see these things that he has made. I don't know where they come up with this kind of imagery and creation. It's like something in their mind, and they just bring it to life in these masks that these people wore and were created. It was just amazing to see what they do. And how many they make, it's just,
The horse.
The horse, yeah. It was just something I had never seen before. And it was great to see how they were made, and
you,
how many they had.
You know, you had an oxymoron on there. You call them lifelike. They're dead.
No.
Life, like,
no,
dead.
You're not, like, real, though, you know?
They looked authentic, is what you're saying? They looked genuine, they didn't look, like...
They look fake.
What?
They don't look fake.
Life, like zombies, okay.
You stop. You know what I meant.
I know, it just strikes me funny, that's all.
Yeah, you're funny.
Alright, so anyhow, for my selection, I kind of was thinking of doing something vintage like Equinox, which is an incredibly creative mind that did that one. But it always came back to two movies, and there's so many others that you should get it, but one of them, of course, is John Carpenter's The Thing. I'm sure this is going to be a pick for a lot of them. It stands well nearly 30 years later. Everything done practical from the Blair creature to the The spider head and the chest bursting open and the dog's head burst. Oh, all of that stuff. Incredible. But one movie kind of trumped it for one reason only, and they didn't hide anything, and that would be American Werewolf in London. We're talking about, this was a time when you had a couple of movies, werewolf movies, show some really major strides in effects for their life and folk change. And, of course, The Howling was one, but that a lot of it was done with darkness and shadows covering it. Of course, American Werewolf was done in a room with regular lighting, so you actually saw everything go on. And there was no CGI in that day. It was all practical. And, for that, Rick Baker just did a fantastic job and really made strides for the industry itself. So that is my choice. I think I really haven't seen anything quite like it since. The werewolf change in American Werewolf in London is definitely my choice for best practical effects in a horror movie, but there are so many of them that absolutely blow us away and keep us coming back and looking for more. And, there's just so many guys out there, from Savini to the guys at K&VFX, that's who you're talking about, the Grim Reaper Carol, the list goes on and on, and I'm not going to drone on about all these guys. You know who they are. So, that's our picks. Walking Dead would be Life Like Dead People. And my pick, American Werewolf in London, will be Werewolf Changing in Full View of Everyone and Lights On. So, we'll be back with Day 38, your favorite horror movie CGI effect. Okay?
Right.